Hello everyone. In the last video, I explained how to generate a amplitude modulated signal by using pitching modulator. Now, in this video, we will understand how to demodulate the signal, an amplitude modulated signal, by using envelope detector. Now, what is demodulation is? See, the modulation process is where we convert a low frequency message signal into the high frequency carrier signal by changing the amplitude of the carrier signal proportional to the amplitude of the message signal. Now, in the demodulation process, what we have to do is we have to convert back this modulated signal into the original message signal. That means the same high frequency carrier should be converted back into the low frequency message signal, bringing back the amplitude variation. So basically, we can perform this by using the demodulator. It is also called a detector. So we are understanding one type of method that is called envelope detector in this video. Now, basically, there are two different types of demodulation, and they are, the first one is square law demodulator, the other one is envelope detector. A square law demodulator is nothing but it is a non-linear demodulator. Envelope detector is a linear diode detector or linear diode demodulator. Depending on which portion of the characteristic of the diode we are operating, depending on that, we can have a square law demodulation as well as envelope detection. The major difference between these two, the envelope detector and the square law detector, is the envelope detector is actually used for demodulating the high level modulated signals. Okay, and whereas this square law demodulator is used to demodulate or detect a low level modulated signal, where, for example, the voltage below 1 ohm. In both the cases, actually, we are using the diodes and some resistor capacitor filters. Okay. In the envelope detector, it is based on switching action, the switching characteristic of the diode. Okay. Now, as you already know, time domain equation for AM is nothing but this. This is the conventional AM equation, okay, where the amplitude of the message signal actually changes accordingly. The amplitude of this carrier with the frequency of FC also changes. Now, what do you mean by envelope detection is? What is the meaning of envelope is, first of all? So, the envelope is in general is given by, it is nothing but it is the root of sum of square of the in-phase component and the quadrature component. Now, if I go back to this equation here, I have only the in-phase component, the quadrature component is 0. The in-phase component is having the amplitude which is equal to this. Okay. So, the square of the in-phase component I have taken, that is AC square 1 plus KA m of t whole square plus the quadrature component is absent, that is 0. So, the root of square of this is nothing but, I can say AC into 1 plus KA m of t, the root cancels over there, it is AC into KA AC m of t, that's what I'll get. So, when I detect the envelope of the AM wave, what I will get is some DC parameter, which will be anyway element can be removed. The second part is AC into KA, which is a constant, right, peak amplitude of the carrier. And m of t is the required signal. So, that means when I detect the envelope of the AM wave, I will get back the message signal, that is m of t. Now, how exactly we are doing this? I will explain by using a circuit diagram, a simple circuit diagram. So, I said we are using a diode in the envelope detector. It's basically nothing but it is a rectifier, a simple rectifier or a linear diode demodulator. Okay. So, for this linear diode demodulator, I have given an AM wave. So, this AM wave is given over here. Okay. In series with some resistance RS. Fine. Now, capacitor and resistor, this is a load resistor, this is a capacitor, simple capacitor filter which is connected in parallel to the load resistor. So, this actually forms a simple envelope detector. So, when I give this signal, a modulated signal with a varying amplitude, what exactly happens is, this diode will be turned on during the positive half cycle, and during negative half cycle, it is act like an open switch. Either a closed switch or open switch. During the positive half cycle, it acts like a closed switch. During the negative half cycle, it acts like a closed switch. So, we get only positive cycles. That's it. So, just look at this. This the output of the diode is given by this. Okay, I get only the positive half cycles. So, when there is only positive half cycles, then what happens is, when it is short circuited, only positive half cycle will be transferred to the capacitor and capacitor will charge and discharge. So, something like this will get. If the charging and discharging is selected properly, that is charging and discharging time, if it is selected perfectly, I will get back, or you can say the envelope of the message signal will be obtained back, something like this. This is the original signal. Okay. Now, what is the time constant for while doing the charging process, and what is the time constant during the discharging process. That you will understand now. Okay, now the time, when, what should be the value of this so that you get a perfect demodulated signal, something like this, without any distortion. So that's what we have to understand now. Okay, the charging happens through this particular path, right? So this is the path. So we have a charging path, something like this. I will show you with a pen. This is charging. This is what the charging happens. So this is the charging which happens through this capacitor. Now, what are the components I have? I have a RS, and this diode will have a certain forward resistance when it is followed by us. Let us say that is RF. Okay, this is the forward resistance. The overall resistance is RS plus RF. Into C is the charging time. You know that time constant T is equal to R into C, right? In general, okay. Here R is nothing but it is RS plus RF. That is the charging time. Now, what is the condition? This charging time RF plus RS into C should be small or short compared to the 1 by FC. That is the time constant of this modulated signal, because this is the carrier frequency and this is the time constant of the signal, right? Isn't it? This is, let us say, some TC. 1 by TC is FC, the carrier frequency. Correct. So this time constant should be short enough compared to the 1 by FC. That is the first condition. So I can say that RF plus RS into C should be very much smaller compared to 1 by FC. That is, if the time constant is very short, what happens is the charging happens very fast. Okay. If I show it by using a representation, the charging happens, because charging time is very, very short or less, the charging happens quickly, something like this. You can see the charging happens quickly, something like this. Okay. Now, what about discharging time constant? So here, the discharging happens through which path? The discharging happens through this particular path, right? Isn't it? So the discharging time is given by here. I can say it is equal to RL into C. So this RL into C is the discharging time. Capacitor should discharge very slowly. It should charge fast, but it should discharge slowly. So when it charges, say, fastly and discharges slowly, and it holds the charge, and when it gets the peak of the other cycle, again it will charge quickly and it will hold the charge for a long time duration, something like this. Again it will charge fast, something like this. It should not, if the time constant is selected short or less, smaller time constant, what happens? It will discharge quickly, something like this. You may get a distortion. I will show you this in the next slide. Okay, now, so the condition what we need to satisfy here is the RLC, this RLC, the discharging time, should be very much greater than 1 by FC, but it should be less than 1 by W, where W is the frequency of the message signal, or it is the message bandwidth, let us say. Okay, now, just look at this example. If the depth of the modulation is more than 1, how the distortion will result? Okay, now just look at this. This is a modulated signal where we have a phase reversal, right? Some distortion is there, correct? The depth of the modulation is more than 1. So this is what the output of the, let us say, this is the output of the diode, okay? This is the output of the capacitor filter. Just look at this. It is having, just 1 second, give me a second. Yes, this is distorted kind of recovered message signal, right? So the condition is the modulation index or depth of the modulation should be less than 1. Now going to the next part, as I told earlier, if I choose very short and very long, what exactly happens? The time constant should be long, right? And the time discharging time constant should be short. If I choose ulta, what happens? Opposite, if I choose, say, time constant, charging time constant is very, very short. Okay, now what happens here? If it is very, very short or a small time duration, let us say 1 nanosecond, okay? So if there is no time to charge and discharge, right? The capacitor, what happens is capacitor will charge and discharge suddenly. So you get some kind of a distortion in the demodulated signal, correct? Now in case if it is too long, say 1 millisecond, maybe 10 millisecond, what happens? Just look at this. It may discharge something like this. That means it is actually missing the peaks of so many cycles. This is the problem actually we face in the demodulation. So we need to choose the time constant, RC time constant, in the envelope detector properly according to this particular condition what I have listed over earlier. So this is the condition we need to satisfy. These are the very, very important condition to get back the signals without any much distortion in the demodulated signal. Okay, so in this video we have understood how this envelope detector works. So thank you for watching this video.